Sorrow. No clicking. No typing. Just sit your fucking ass still.
All right. Welcome to Oculus Episode 2. And we're back. And this time we have...
me! Stennis.
You may know him from Oculus V1, that alternate lighter timeline, and now he's back in dark and gritty, just like the rest of us.
So. And he's taking selfies.
Yeah, we're so gritty.
We're so gritty, we take selfies.
And damn straight, we put it on our Instagram page, you know?
Our Oculus Instagram of just sorrow. Now we have sorrow selfies as well.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Wow.
All right. Well, I'm Eric, the Ripper, 1928.
I'm Romie, the Romie Dogs, 2.
I am Jordan, first of his name, Lord of the Seven Kingdoms, Protector of the Realm, and all these people are just mindless peasants that worship me.
I'm Richard.
No secrets.
Richard.
Fucking Saga Cutison.
Are you going to introduce yourself over there?
Yeah, I just did. Richard.
He introduces Twitter.
Okay. Introduce your Twitter. We'll deal with that at the end. You want to start off with what you did? You had, like, an interesting weekend.
I went to RTX 2014. It was, Da Bomb Diggity. This is my third RTX.
Get laid there.
Had a lot of fun.
Haven't you?
Oh yeah, I banged everybody. All the guys, all the gals, all the hermaphrodites.
Nice.
Very inclusive.
Shame I didn't go.
Yeah, you could have got banged too.
We could have had nice machines.
Jordan, we're supposed to go.
Me, Sorrow, and Ripper could have had a threesome.
Yeah, we could have, but you know, Sorrow couldn't go because his parents thought he'd get abducted. You couldn't go just because your parents had some timing issues.
And I couldn't.
I mean, yep.
I told Romy to go hitchhike his way there, but he didn't want.
You can join that robot in Canada that's trying to hitchhike across country.
What?
You didn't know about that?
No,
There's a robot that's been made, and it's trying to hitchhike from, I don't remember, I think Montreal, to whatever the Pacific coast is. I don't know any significant cities. I forgot the actual information. Probably.
The only significant
Toronto,
place
that
is Toronto.
All.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever.
That was right. Winnipeg comes up from now and then.
Vancouver.
Montreal, I don't know. Yeah, there's that. So there's not much. When most of the time when you think of Canada, Toronto is like the first place to pop up in your head.
that's the first thing that pops in my head when I think of it.
Wait, what pops up in your head?
Toronto.
Your mom.
Toronto when you
that's
think
it.
Of New York due to what was it? Resident Evil? Because fuck. I think it was.
Toronto is the new New York.
It's new New York.
What is this, Futurama?
It's the cheaper place to film if you want to film in New York but can't.
You're right. I just watched that episode yesterday.
What did you do at the RTX?
Well, as Jordan pointed out, I banged everything.
Well, yes, that's a major important part of RTX.
But I sat in a lot of lines for a lot of time to see quite a few of the panels. I should. So much tweets. Well, let's see. I think, what was the first thing I did? I walked around the floor, of the exhibit hall. And, I mean, you know, that wasn't, there wasn't really anything that, you know, special this year for the exhibit hall. Like, 2 years ago, I got to be one of the first 8 people to play Halo 4 multiplayer. Yeah, that was badass. But, so yeah, the exhibit hall wasn't all that. Trying to think of what I saw first, but I can't remember.
Other than all the penises.
Oh, well, I also saw all the vaginas. Come on, can't be, you know, biased.
I'm sorry.
What did I see first? Well, forget what I saw first. I saw the red versus blue panel at one point, and it was fucking amazing. Because we got to see the episode that aired today, actually. Well, technically yesterday. Which is, like, the Federal Army, of course, where it shows the other side of the battle. You guys don't even watch it, so. whatever. It was really fucking awesome to watch it with, like, 2,000 people in one room. It was really explosively amazing. I can't really say anything about it. It's out. You can watch it. I don't care. At the very beginning, there was some chick walking around who was cosplaying as Hodor. Yeah, Jordan, about... Oh, yeah, definitely. About 12 hours after I tweeted to Jordan that somebody was cosplaying, he was like, get pics. yeah, let me just go and find this person that I saw 12 hours ago.
Was it 12 hours ago?
Sorry, 8. There's a very significant amount of time.
It's not like it's like difficult to find somebody cosplaying as Hodor.
Yeah, it is if they, you know, switched their costume.
Well, that's a possibility.
Also, there were 30,000 people this year. So
your excuses.
You're right. My excuses.
People, but you banged them all.
But she was the first one. I mean, how am I supposed to find the first one when I have to hit every single person? No. It wasn't that good of a cosplay.
Well, watch the person who wasn't cosplaying as Hodor, and you're just offensive.
That could be. But that would mean the other, like, hundreds of people that were like, Hodor! Hodor! As she walked down and she was cheering about it. Yeah.
Well, because at that point, she's probably already heard it throughout her entire life, and since Game of Thrones came out, and now just accepted it. That's what I think happened. You're all just terrible.
Yeah, we're all just mean people.
Yeah.
Another thing at RTX was I went to the Achievement Hunter panel. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. All the sounds just stopped. Again.
I'm currently battling the bugs of the summer in my room. This is pissing me off.
Nice.
I've been like 8 since the beginning of the podcast, and they're still coming.
Hey, Romie, so you know, like, the weather you have now where it's, like, 70-ish degrees?
It was like 90.
That kind of weather?
Earlier.
Oh, man, you got to 90? Well, guess what? That's winter for us.
That is, that's so sad.
Winter is coming.
Winter's not gonna make it down here. The White Walkers are gonna show up and be like, fuck this place! But I saw the Achievement Hunter panel, and it opened up, like, so friggin' retardedly amazing. They had this, like, super slow-mo intro thing, and it was so badass. It was, like, Michael and Gavin were surgeon simulators, and they had a liver in there. Jeff spit some really expensive alcohol into Jack's face. Caleb got frisbees disced into his face by, Jeff's daughter. Yeah. Lindsay was yelling at Caden, who's, like, since you guys probably don't know, is, like, one of the newer achievement hunters.
Your achievement
hunter? That's background all the time. Oh, man, speaking of that, at the panel, it's funny, like, people didn't know this, but, there's these two guys who make a lot of videos for Achievement Hunter. I can't remember their things. But they make a lot of videos. They're in a lot of them. And they've even been featured in, like, actual Achievement Hunter videos a couple times. And so they were at the panel, and they just had this rehearsed joke or whatever, where they came up to the mic to ask questions, and they're like, we're blah, 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 and blah, blah, blah. Can we get a job? And so, just like...
What'd they say?
Yeah, you know, just like, yeah, you know what, you two are hired. Come on up. And they're like, oh, I guess y'all should have asked before them, because nobody else asked. I mean, how are you guys... All you had to do was ask. So all these people are, like, in line, like, oh, what? They're all, like, angry and shit. There was one girl, like, on the camera right behind them, like, her face just lit up with, like, excitement and anger, just like, what? That was funny. Yeah, and so they actually had them go sit up on stage. Yeah, well, I think they're actually already working for them, and they just did that as a joke. But they had them come sit up on stage, so the whole time they were just up on stage sitting quietly.
Wow.
That was funny. They didn't actually hire them for asking the question. They made videos regularly.
Aww. We understood the joke. Well, I did. I understood it.
That's good. Gotta have some kind of understanding.
No one understands?
No one understands.
No one understands anything about Game of Thrones.
So, Cesaro.
So.
Yes.
It's okay, Cesaro, it happens.
Understands. Did you do anything super amazingly interesting this week, like save the world?
You'll never know.
Oh.
That's true. But we also won't ever know, because Saro won't ever leave his house, except for when he has to go release radiation somewhere else.
Jordan, you want to talk about your internet?
They already know.
My what?
Oh, yeah. Internet fame. Your Twitter fame.
My
I was talking
fame.
About your ask fame.
Can we not? let's drop the subject. Actually, I'm going to leave my ask right now.
Why? All you have to
it's
do is turn
me.
Up a different
it
picture,
keeps on notifying me on my phone.
Why would you turn the notifications on for that?
Yeah, that's it.
I was bored at work one day. And I needed something.
Wow.
Well, and you got something.
Well, that reminds me of my story that I was going to talk about on here.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so apparently, this one girl, she was born without eyelids, and so to fix that, they removed some skin. They removed, actually, it was a guy, never mind. They removed some skin from his foreskin and made eyelids out of it. So, this one guy has
foreskin everywhere now.
up until you got to foreskin, I was like, well, I mean, this happens. People get their, you know, skin from their, like, upper thigh or ass taken and put it in replaced to places. But foreskin, that's some really thick skin that they're going to put on his eyes.
Yeah, that's what I read about. That's why I had to be there.
Shit. Who doesn't want penis vision?
I mean, I do. I don't know about you guys.
That would be the best, is it? Join you in what? Are you going to cut off your foreskin and put it on your eyes? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
You're not circumcised?
This conversation.
It's okay, Jordan. It's okay.
You can tell. It's an open zone. Come on, Jordan.
All right.
You don't have to hide. Like, Sar can tell you about it.
This is a safe place.
Yeah.
Dude, like, if Starro ever actually did go outside, like, all the girls would just flock to him because he's got, like, an enormous, beautiful penis.
Right.
They just wouldn't be able to help themselves.
Starro,
yeah.
Yep. Turn
your
cam on.
Okay.
Turn your cam on.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
Oh my god, it's an audio. You know this is an audio podcast, right?
We went over this. We spent 5 minutes. We spent 5 minutes on not turning the camera on. Nidus, I just moved the wires, you know.
So, anybody else bring anything?
Yeah. So along with Rooster Teeth and RTX, Laser Team is like they're making a feature film. It's called Laser Team, and they were crowdfunding it on Indiegogo, and they got up to $2.5 million this weekend. Yeah, they're badasses. And they also had open auditions at RTX, which I participated in. I expect nothing, but that'd be really cool if I could work on it. Although I'm sure it would clash with my schedule for college.
YOLO, you're an actor now.
Yeah, fuck education.
Your college schedule now revolves around Laser Team.
You are.
That's fine.
AMOUS. You are famous. Okay? Don't let anyone else tell you.
Famous. PHAMOUS. Famous. PHAMOUS.
Are you having fun?
Yeah. I like that song.
These bugs are going to be the death of me.
What?
These bugs, they are going to be the death of me. I hate
them. Paul. Boss.
You should get that fixed.
Yeah. Should.
Okay.
You should get that fixed, Romie. Lucky you, Jordan.
I rarely ever see cockroaches. Maybe once every, 3 years.
That's like a year for me.
It's funny. Down here, sometimes you'll see, a cockroach eating a rat. It happens.
They just don't give a fuck.
Are they super rad roaches over there?
Yeah. They can be the size of your hand.
Miss my college. I miss my college right now. There was no bugs. There's the occasional fly, and that was it. And then there's the occasional big bug in the showers, and then I just don't care because it's
specifically in the shower.
Yeah, it would be on the wall and just be chilling. I'd be like, whatever. You can stay, I guess.
You can hang, look at me naked. I know that's what you want to do.
I mean, I don't have anything exactly on me to kill it. I'm not, so.
You could punch it and then just rinse your hand off.
I could, but then that would require me touching it.
But also, there's no need to kill the bugs. I mean, if they're not actually, dangerous or a problem. It was a problem. It was a really poisonous spider. It was just waiting, for somebody to just get really close and it'd bite its penis or its nipple or something.
Remember that time that Starro almost lost his finger until he told him about that spider bite?
Wait, what?
Because you were gone.
If it was a spider bite.
Okay, so Starro, we'll talk about this. Starro, one day, he woke up, and he was just, on Xbox. We were just on Xbox, and he's like, my finger, it just, I woke up, and it just hurts. It's a little swollen, it just hurts.
Yeah, and it was pretty painful at the time.
Wow. And so I was like, so what'd you do? Did you, he was like, I don't know, I just woke up. I was like, did you sleep on it? He's like, I don't think so. Well, you might have, broken it in your sleep or twisted it or something, that happens. And he's like, what? That's not, what? And I was like, yeah, you could have broken it or something. He's like, oh, okay, well, I'll leave it. I was like, well, just go a couple days. If it gets worse, then you might need to, get that checked out or something. And then he was like, well, okay, whatever. And then the next day he comes back, he's like, Yeah, now my finger is like really huge and it's like purple, almost black. It's like, yeah, you should just go tell your parents or something. And then he goes and tells them that it's like it might have gotten broken in his sleep or something. And then they're like, oh, okay. And he comes back, he's like, yeah, guys, I'm gonna go to the emergency room. I'll be back. No, he's like, yeah, my parents made an appointment. I'm gonna leave soon though, so I'll be back. And then he's gone for like an hour or two, comes back, he's like, yeah, well, they don't know exactly what it was, but they think that it was a spider that bit my finger, and that if I had come like a day later, it could have been dead. Could have lost the finger.
The exact spider was the reclusive brown spider. You should look at some pictures.
God, you should see pictures of that shit. And that's, you have to deal with that possibly coming into your house at night and biting you on anywhere. It's, they're the worst. It's.
The story was Sarah didn't get any superpowers, so that's up.
We told you about the giant penis, right?
Oh, but I thought he always had that.
Yeah, so he doesn't need any superpowers.
Oh, okay, now I see your point is made.
I'm glad I could get that across. Then you should go have sex in a forest.
With the picnic basket
on a blanket.
No. The first time, it was on sticks. The second time, it was on a blanket.
Maybe it was on both. You don't know his life. He's a player.
Hey, he said it. He said it those ways. He was like, yeah, we went out, and it was, you know, on the sticks and shit, and it was rough.
He says he's inviting strippers to his house for his birthday.
So that means I'm invited.
Yeah.
I thought we weren't supposed to use the S word with you, Romie.
I've accepted my full stripperness now.
That's good. That's good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Glad to have you on the team.
Good. Instead of laser team, it's stripper team.
Yep. The world's gonna be saved by a few strippers.
Yep.
Nice. Yeah, that's a good movie.
I mean, yeah.
Oh, I know what movie you're talking about.
Wait, are you talking about zombie strippers or whatever?
I saw that.
Yeah, zombie strippers.
I've seen that. Well, I haven't watched it, but, like, I know it exists.
I saw it once, you know, on a shelf in Blockbuster. Get it? Blockbuster. There are still some. I see some still. It's just, it's like anytime we were on a football trip or whatever for school, we would pass by one on the way to like the most rural cities. Blockbuster can still make a living where they can't get the internet.
Yeah, because now all they see is Redbox.
They have Blockbuster. They have Blockbuster. They have Blockbuster boxes like that.
So yeah, Blockbuster did also have like a service before Netflix, I believe, but just no. It's kind of like Yahoo Stream.
Yahoo Stream.
Yeah, it's kind of like that. Yeah, Jordan, you want to talk about that, Jordan?
What is there to talk about that?
Yahoo Stream?
No. One of our favorite shows is going to be on
Yahoo. No one is going to watch Community because of Yahoo Stream.
I mean, they might. Watch it blow up in popularity because of Community.
Yahoo Stream's going to overtake Netflix?
Yeah. Because, like, who doesn't want to put their show on there? Come on.
I heard Netflix wants to do something really dumb. I don't know if you know anything about that. They want,
the really dumb thing they want to do? Yeah, it's really detailed.
Yeah, that really dumb thing? They want to, like...
I was going to do it, but you interrupted me.
What were you going to say?
Let me find the article.
They paid... They, he said that they're thinking about making everybody pay per movie that they rent.
Ew. I hope that's not real. They are making an anime, so...
Yeah, it's already on Netflix, by the way. It's, Nicest Cydonia.
Well,
what's it about?
It's about
butt sex.
The story is that humanity has mostly died out, and it focuses on one of the characters who's in, like, an isolated community in like, a space station.
Oh, man, speaking of humanity dying out, day 5, Bad Grandpa, they actually put Bad Grandpa 0.5 on Netflix.
I saw it.
Yeah, 0.5. You know, like, yeah. One, like, half, Netflix. Just the background stuff. But, yeah, but I was gonna say that, Rooster Teeth is day 5, which is, like, a thing they like, started 2 years ago, but never actually got much recording for it. They actually have it, almost wrapped up and ready to come out, and it's gonna be badass. It's, it's a story of, it's there, so the story of it is, if you go to sleep, you die. You never wake up again. You just die if you go to sleep. So what happens, what they've said so far is that, like, their apocalypse thing doesn't take place like how you usually would. So it's like people are driving or whatever, you know, just at night. It takes place like the thing starts like midday or whatever. Or wait, what does, yeah. So like everybody's, so like they don't know that if you go to sleep, you die, and people are just driving around. So whatever. So it's not like the other things. And then we recorded like a part of it at, Rooster Teeth 2 years ago. They finally actually did something with it. But I have nothing, actually. It's just, you go to sleep, you die. It starts on the 5th day. That's why it's called day 5. It hasn't come out yet, so I don't have any information. I was just saying.
It sounds interesting.
Yeah, it's a different kind of apocalypse, man. The highways won't be choked. You could actually leave if you wanted to.
None of you guys here watch Once Upon a Time, right?
Not caught up.
Either way,
saw the first few episodes.
Characters shall
Romie,
be.
They're on Netflix.
What?
I know.
Romie, where do you find the time to watch these shows? I mean, after all, you're in the military.
Yeah. Apparently, one of our friends on Xbox, who I haven't talked to in a while, was in a party today and. From somebody. Military? Because he was like, I'm in college now. And he was like, what? Somebody told me you joined like the military or something.
I don't think anybody told him that. I think he just made that up on his own.
On his own.
Yeah.
Still pretty far off from me. Yeah, no.
Well, Romie, you do have that like military boldness going on.
I'm not even bald. I'm going to kill you.
Romie.
It's the only
thing. I got paired up with, for the auditions or whatever for RTX. I got paired up with this one guy. And he's, you know, it's going to sound like I'm describing you, but I swear it's not. He's this black guy who's, who's really into acting. He actually has a degree. It did. It's gotta be racist. If it's not racist, nobody cares. You gonna dispute that? Are you gonna dispute that? You care because it's racist.
Well, shut up. Carry on with your damn story.
No, I'm good.
No, well... Continue describing me. Then go on. The me is...
No, it's okay.
Okay.
It's racist. It's racist. I can't describe him, Romy. It's...
You know what? Just fuck you.
Well, Romy, if you had come to RTX, you could have. I mean...
Well...
Fucked everybody.
You'd ask me... Like, you acted them first, so they were top priority.
You weren't talking to me for 9 months.
I don't remember that, and technically I didn't talk to any of you guys when I'm on.
Bullshit, you did. You talked to Jordan, and you talked to everybody else through, like, messaging and tweeting and anything else. Hey, what do they consist of now, Romy? Nothing.
No, me and Jordan have meaningful conversations on Facebook all day. Talk about life.
We'll have one right now. We have a podcast. Have a meaningful conversation right now.
We can't. You guys are here.
Jordan. Wait, Jordan. Yeah. Nice. You want to have a meaningful conversation? So sailboat is sure. Air sex?
Yeah. It is, like, amazing. It's air sex, and...
Like,
that's all.
I put it on repeat for 2 hours while I went to sleep. Like, I set the timer. I've never done that.
Yeah, I fell asleep. I fell asleep within a sailboat, and then...
Yeah, that was
the best. Blark! I think I'm going to do that again, and then I'm going to write down my thoughts after, when I wake up.
You should draw some pictures about it.
I also did that for Zombies 3.
Nice.
When it came out, I fell asleep listening to it, and then I wrote down my answers.
What kind of images comes from sleeping with that playing in your ear?
It was very... I right before I got to sleep, I got like a notepad pen. Then, as soon as I woke up, I immediately started drawing stuff.
Fucking Joe from Blue School's over here. Yeah, I didn't call you Steve, because you don't deserve that. So you were Joe, and no one liked you.
What happened
to that guy? I know what happened to Steve. I know what happened to him. He's funny and awesome. What happened to Joe? Did he just quit everything, because no one liked him?
Well... There was a big thing where everybody was like, oh man, yeah, he died, he overdosed on cocaine, or whatever. But that didn't happen. He did do drugs, and they caught him, so so he couldn't be Joe anymore. So they fired him, and then he just went off and started doing, like, miscellaneous acting things. And then, you know, became a drug addict, and... You know, that happens.
Shiitake happens.
Shiitake mushrooms happen. Mushroom! Sorrow said mushrooms.
Oh. Jordan, did you see the Walking Dead Season 5 tease?
Yeah.
Yay.
Wait, you saw it?
I'd like to hear more because there's Carol. There's Carol and,
yeah, pretty much. Only character I care, Carol and Tyrese.
Not Judith.
Yeah. Not Judith. The baby who doesn't exist to us until she dies. So that's when she'll get her name back. Once that baby dies, we'll gladly call her by the name.
Yeah.
Baby.
You did it.
So, do we have anything else we'd like to talk about?
Jordan.
We have very interesting lives and do everything every day. And
oh, yeah, all the time.
Jordan yeah. predicted that Ripper has cancer.
So, Ripper has cancer, according to Dr. Oaks over there, who scientifically deducted that Ripper has cancer because his foot was itchy. Like, very itchy, but there was no actual bump or anything there. So,
like you know, one of those itches that just comes up out of nowhere, and it's not itchable. It's just, like, a painful itch inside of your skin that you can't touch at all. Just there. Yeah, one of those. And then Romy was really surprised that Jordan came to this conclusion of cancer, but I was like, well, that's actually a thing. Sometimes if you're just itching uncontrollably in a certain spot for no reason whatsoever, you might have cancer. Probably just paranoid. I was going to say paranoia, but that's why that paranoid sounded like paranoid. But whatever. But yeah. Yep. But I did just remember a thing. At RTX. I was standing in line to see the immersion panel. And then, you know, I pulled my phone out of my pocket and I was going to use it and, you know, type some messaging to somebody or something. And then, you know, it fumbled out of my hand, you know, just how things do sometimes. But instead of, like, the casual fumble where it just falls next to your foot, it decided it was going to fly, like, 5 feet away from me. And so, as it flies 5 feet away from me, it hits, like, this wall that's, like, a railing. But, like, we're on, like, the... We're, like, 50 feet up or whatever. It's, like, technically the second floor. But, yeah, so we're up. We're up, like, 50 feet. And this railing isn't actually, like, attached. Like, it's not a full... It's not fleshed out with the side. It, like, sticks out, like, 4 inches. And then, you know, there's just space there. So my phone went and flew into the railing side, like, hit the wall, fell, and I saw it. I was like, okay, and I go over to get it. And I see it just lean into the hole, and it just takes a tumble. I was like, no. And I look over the edge, and I have enough time. I have enough time to walk 6 feet and look over the edge and see it fall for another second before it hits the ground. I was at, like, the mid-front of the line. After this was like standing there for 2 hours, and I was like, wow. God damn it. And like, we had just started like 30 minutes ago, we had just started to slowly feed into the actual like line, like the waiting area. We were just in a pre-waiting area. And so I was like, God damn it. And so I have to go. They turned off the down, like, they made all the escalators go up where we were, so that way it funneled everybody the direction they needed. So I was like, God damn it. So I had to go all the way down the other end of the fucking thing to go down the escalators, and then I had to run all the way back around to go and find my phone. I get there, and I'm like, it's not on the ground anymore. I'm like, oh shit, I see these two kids just, like, standing off to the side. And they're looking, like, sort of baffled. And I'm like, I look to them, I'm like, hey. And they're like, they put up the phone. I'm like, yeah. They're like, okay, good. Because we were like, we saw it fall. We're just like, how does that happen? I was like, yeah, I don't know. And I was like, oh, thank you. I was like, I was in the line for emergency. Like, oh, how's that line anyway? I was like, it's like a couple thousand people extra. I mean, you know, they're like, oh, fuck. And they're like, well, do you want this Sharpie? It seemed to fall, too. I was like, "What? Okay, whatever, sure, I'm going to go back." And so I was like, fuck. So I go back up the escalators, and I was like, I hope they didn't send, like, the people I was in front of, like, up already. Otherwise, I'm not going to get back into the line without an argument. And so I was like, I go up there, I'm looking, I'm like, oh my God, yes, so there's people. The people I was being, like, right in front of were just right there. And I was like, oh my God, thank you. I was like, would you let me back in line, please? Like, oh yeah, just come back in. We saw that. That was just, oh, that was awful. Well, they didn't like me later because I did actually cut the line at a different point and just took off with them. But, was, you know, that's another thing. But so, how does your phone look? And I was like, you know, it's actually fine. It's just got this line down the side. They're like, oh yeah, man, these fucking OtterBoxes, what badasses, you know, for an iPhone. I was like, yeah, okay, not much of a problem with it. About 20 minutes later, you know, look at my phone. It's exploding random colors. It's like, you know, it's like sometimes it just stops and the screen's just like a pale white. And I mean, it still works now. It's actually still broken. I'm using it to record me. So it still works. But, you know, so it's just really, really hard to see sometimes. Right now, the screen is actually like, it looks like an old-timey camera where it has like a faded black, like, ring around the outside of, like, everything that's in the middle. It's kind of got that look to it right now. I'm getting it replaced, like, Wednesday. Which is good. Because I need a phone so I can apply for jobs and shit. So they can call me.
Well, lucky you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, very lucky me that I chucked my phone about 50 feet.
Yeah, I think that's
that.
The greatest thing you've ever done.
One time, this was like 6 years ago or whatever, whenever it was, there weren't iPhones. It was just an iPod Touch. And so we had a family reunion or whatever. I didn't want to go to it, but I had to go to it. And so we went up, and it's up in like Montana or something, and I had my iPod, and I forgot it was in my pocket when, like, at one point we went walking up a river, you know, just for the fun of it, because we're bored as fuck, because we're in the middle of Montana doing nothing. Anyway, so we're walking up the river, and I ended up slipping. Towards the part where we were going to walk out, I ended up slipping and falling in because of moldy rocks and shit. Wait, mildew. No, what is it? Not mold, whatever.
Mossy?
Whatever the thing is. Moss. Mossy rocks. There you go. And so I slip on the rocks, and I fall in. I'm like, ah, so I get out, and I start pulling things out of my pocket. For some reason, I got Sharpies and pens and you know, fucking whatever. So I pull out my up, and I'm like, ah. So I suck the water as much as I can out of it and just spit that out. I'm like, whatever. And it's like, great. And so, you know, 2 hours later, we end up coming back to wherever we were staying. And I was like, okay. So it's dried. I put it in some rice that we had, whatever. Put in the rice, whatever. Next day, check it. I'm like, okay. Plugged it in. I was like, all right, it actually still works. But it only worked to the point where it would turn, it would, you know, the click, the power on and power off. Like, it's not shut down. It would just click on and off, 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 on and off. You couldn't do anything. Like, if you had headphones, you could plug it in and press the play thing, because they actually had that back then. But that's all you could do. I was like, great. So this is lovely. When we got back home from the trip, I decided, I was like, well, I can't actually use it now. Let me try this. So I go in the bathroom, turn on the faucet, run the thing under the water, and click the power button a couple of times, and then, you know, just suck the water out, throw it in some rice, let it dry. Come back to it, use it. I'm like, oh, it works perfectly fine. Worked amazingly. Worked great. Just like normal. And then about, 6 hours later, the backlight blew out, so I couldn't actually, you can still use it. It's still usable now. And it was just, if you want to see the screen, yeah, if you want to see the screen, you have to shine a light at it, like a flashlight or something, because there is no backlit stuff, so you can't see what's there without extra light. Yeah.
You have a technology struggle.
I sure do. I have that right here, actually. I can pull that out, and I'm going to play a sound from it.
Hopefully, though.
It might, the batteries in the, oh shit, they might have fucking did that acid thing where they exploded. Who knows?
Maybe you'll get super ouch.
Oh, hey, no, it's, oh, yep, I see it. Let me just throw these away real quick.
So, in the meantime, anybody else have anything interesting?
Butt sex.
Romie.
That's
me.
Can we Game of Thrones, and I'll love you forever.
What? You want me to read Game of Thrones? See.
Yeah, go read Song of Ice and Fire.
Enjoy time. He'll suck your dick. He'll suck your dick, Romie.
Sorrow, go read them.
Listen, just
understand.
Just listen to the audiobook.
Understand.
Just listen to the audiobook.
Actually, wait, no, that's acceptable. Because the reader for that is pretty cool.
Okay.
No, I'm good. I'll stick with vaguely watching the show and having, colors go past my eyes because people are doing things.
It sounds like you're doing things like acid.
maybe that might cause me to pay attention to the show more. I don't know. But, for me and Game of Thrones, I kind of floated through watching the first and second season. Actually, wasn't there an incident in which I was watching it on HBO Go, and I started
the second episode
of season two, and I didn't notice anything. I just kept going. So, that's my relationship with Game of Thrones. I only care about a very few select characters. No. I paid attention this season. Because I already know what the characters I care about did.
I care about dead.
Did fuck grammar right now.
Jordan Ramar. Brought and confirmed the kill.
He wanted to hear the mountain of Festers.
You're definitely throwing out spoilers right now.
So, I have my Game Boy on right now. My Game Boy has censored the Nintendo part of the, like, opening thing when it turns on. So there's just a black bar with the, copyright symbol underneath the word Game Boy. Also, the sound, the speaker's dead.
Why do you have your Game Boy on right there?
Because I said I was gonna have it make a sound.
Yeah, that's right. Okay.
What sound?
Oh, wait, hold on. I got it.
Nice.
Hold on.
That sound briefly made me happy. That, there it is.
It's the best sound.
That made me a little happy. I'm all tingling inside.
I'm actually gonna find a Game Boy Color game and start playing.
Renee just texted me.
What did I say?
Sorrow, are you Joker fucking playing it now?
Joker wanted me to ask him if he's talked to Lisa lately, and he says no. But of course he responds at 2 in the morning when I texted him at 7 p.m. But, you know.
Sorrow, you're making too much noise, and that's not your fucking Game Boy Color.
No, it's my DS.
Yeah, so turn it off.
Is it that loud?
Or turn
yes.
It down all the way, Sorrow.
Yeah, either one of those.
Okay, so Sorrow, what's interesting with you? What's going on? Wow, really?
Gold is stored somewhere.
Hey, Sorrow.
Found Zelda.
Yeah.
Sorrow. Yeah. I'm going to sit right now. Why are the Karens going by, like, super fast? Why are they going like, what?
So, I think tomorrow I'm just going to head out to the gym, maybe at around 9-ish.
Nine-ish.
And, like, fly up and come for a run.
Where the fuck's Gold?
We could hit that treadmill.
You know what else we could hit?
Sorrow. we could hit
Sorrow.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, we're just gonna hit you.
Okay.
So cool. Do we have nothing else to talk about? Are we all? What's everyone's plan for the week coming?
What?
Get my phone and find a job.
Nice. You should come to New York and find a job here. I won't.
Sure.
You
want
to
hook
me
up? God damn it! Never mind.
The job part, but you won't stay with me.
Yeah, because a part-time job can afford a fucking apartment in New York.
Well, if you get enough of them.
Yeah, let me go get 5. They overlap at the same place.
Yeah, working on mall is like different kiosks.
Something, they come out, the managers are like, hey, have you seen Eric? He's supposed to be working right now. Oh man, yeah, I had to take him. I needed him for a shift or whatever, but don't worry, you pay him anyway, go ahead. Okay, don't fire him for anything.
Yeah, see, look, you already got the setup, and get an apartment, and then I can come hang out over there, and yeah,
and you can pay to hang out with me, you know, it costs an hour, you know, so.
No, I won't pay.
Nah, you'll pay. Nah, you'll pay.
No, I'll be friend for living with Sorrow. I'll pretend to be Sorrow.
No. Yeah, but Sorrow's never gonna make it to New York, so, no.
You don't know that.
Swear
to
God.
He's gonna come to Comic-Con if I buy him a ticket, right, Sorrow?
Bullshit, he will.
Yeah, what if Sorrow came to Comic-Con with me instead of going to RTX for you?
Yeah, I'll just go to my way to go to
Comic-Con. You didn't stay at my house, you stayed in a hotel, like, near the place. I'm sure his parents would allow it.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Take this trip to New York, So they'll be already like, well, okay.
Oh, yeah, because, you know, me already offering to pay for his hotel and his travel here, you know, and also going to give him extra money just to...
Sorry, you can fly first class.
No, not
if you
just
come
you. It was you and...
Jordan as well.
Wait, what?
We were going to pay Sorrow to come.
Yeah, they were both going to give me, like, $150, pay my share, give me a ticket for free,
you're stupid
drive me
there.
His parents wouldn't let him.
Sorry?
He's also a little bitch.
What you do is you tell them, well, this is a job. I got a job at RTX. I work there. And then you could have went.
I'm thinking of being a guardian next year.
Nice. You should do it.
Does this bring back memories? This is the only game I could find.
Well, no. So you guys should come down to Manhattan now.
Jordan's the only one that can actually come down. We have to go up.
No, we discussed this before. You can just go all the way around.
Yeah. Don't you mean they go all the way down?
Yeah.
They go all the way down. And then,
yeah.
You know, I think I'm actually going to take this around places and just play it whenever I go somewhere.
Well, it's something to do.
Like, the art on, like, this actually looks good. I can actually distinguish everything. I don't have any memory of anything looking okay on a Game Boy Color.
Yeah. So is this the 1950s?
Wait.
No, nothing. You'll remember when you go back and listen to this.
What?
Are you having fun? Can you stop pressing buttons? So I don't have to
yeah,
that?
You know what? I'm actually going to use Google's talk, the speech thing. I forgot what I was going to Google, though. It was something we were talking about.
I don't know.
Oh, wait. No, I was going to go to Ask. Okay, Google. Ask.com. Well, Sorrow suggested that since nobody was saying anything, but yeah, you can talk about movies.
So,
well, Guardians of the Galaxy, I believe it was today.
Not FM.
Whatchamacallit. They showed the first 17 minutes to people who ordered, like, a ticket to this special screening. And all that's coming back from it is nothing but positive remarks on how amazing those first 17 minutes are. And I'm avoiding all the internet spoilers that have a full synopsis of what happened, and it's hurting my soul. I want to read it, but I want to see it. I'm avoiding watching the extended trailer that came out, and it's just...
Hey, Romie. You might get interrupted now by my dog, because, he's having, like, a nightmare.
Aww.
It's okay. It's okay.
Aw, that sounded so cute. Poor thing.
It's alright.
What's having a nightmare?
My favorite dog. Nidus. This is the one that I actually... technically, he's the third dog we've had. But he is the first of the four that I showed you.
I think I remember when you got him.
Yeah, you talked to me then.
That was way before. Yeah, that was like a year ago or something. Like
2 years. No, it's like 3 years ago because you weren't talking to me a year ago. That's when that started.
You like to bring this up. You keep bringing this
up,
it might happen again.
Yeah, it probably will.
Yeah, most likely.
But yeah, so, the other dogs... The other dogs were, they're actually, like, we have two of them, just naturally. Like, the two of them are ours. And then my sister came back to town, and that's where the other dogs, two other dogs came from.
Hmm.
Well, I wish I saw my dog more. I wish I could take him to my college. But, well, should stop saying that. We got upgrade to university status. I wish I could take him back to university with me. It feels very
wait, odd. What?
My college, I went there when it was a college. We got updated to university status. So now we're a university instead of being called a college.
No, it's still a college.
No, we changed the signs and everything.
No, it's still a college. This is America. You go to college. Dude, where did they get that key?
Bug on my finger. Nope, die, please. I hate bugs.
Now Sorrow's dogs are freaking out. It's okay, Nai Nai.
There they go.
Aw. Can't hear my dog freaking out. Maybe he is. We're at my mom's house. I don't know. Okay. Do I have any other movie stuff before we get into the axe questions? Let me look.
Should she make an
Oxalis
account?
What?
We probably actually should.
Why would we participate in actually using that site? Yeah.
I don't know. We could do all the TBFs, TBHs, and we could pour for likes.
I would love to see what that site was when it first came out, because I'm pretty sure it was used for its actual purpose.
I actually just opened it up, and there's a GIF of like 30 people holding up a Dalek, and just spinning in a circle with it.
Jordan sent me that on Facebook.
I saw it.
Yeah, you also sent me it.
But, you know, here's the usual stuff. Rates, TBH, likes equals 5 likes, like equals 15 likes, rates.
Oh.
Likers get a question, that's weird. Get a question.
I just got TBH and I said, no, go away.
Nidus.
Pacific Rim 2 is being made, that's a thing.
I heard about that.
We also have
an animated
series and a graphic novel, so... If you have Pacific Rim is the really super manly movie.
They're oh yeah, super super manly awesome.
Yep, I actually really like that movie, and I really like action related movies. So.
Lol. Actually, so along with Rooster Teeth making, oh no, I just died because I wasn't paying attention.
Look at that.
Along with Rooster Teeth making like a movie, they're actually working on a novel, and they're getting a game made based off of Ruby.
Ooh, I've always wanted that from like day one of seeing Ruby.
Now you'll have
a great game. Because it just looks phenomenally awesome. Like I would play.
Phenomenally.
Phenomenally.
Blah 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 blah
blah blah blah. Okay, we're not doing that.
Why not?
Crab people.
That's a big slime.
Walk
how do I save?
I actually talk don't like have people. Any more news,
yeah, you
so
don't
if you want to go into the
app
thing.
It's good to know.
Okay,
I was going to say, a lot of the time that I was, like, in line... Sure, but a lot of the time I was in line waiting, I was reading, Mockingjay. I think I thought. And I'm at 2/3 now.
Wait, I thought you finished it.
No.
Oh.
I got a wooden sword.
Finish it.
Calm down, no.
Before
no,
you
no,
finish Mockingjay, Sorrow better finish watching fucking Sherlock.
Sorrow, you haven't finished. They're all on Netflix. They're all on Netflix right now.
All on Netflix. All
It's not even having to wait for an episode. They're all on Netflix.
My dog's face keeps flapping.
Taking your time with three episodes a season. That's, Okay. But I have nothing at the moment to, I don't have any other news. The Destiny beta, that's coming. Yeah.
Dark Souls 2's first DLC, The Sunken King, is going to be coming out later this month.
Oh, Dark Souls 2.
I'll be sure to get on that, and I'll suffer through Dark Souls again. Unfortunately.
You have not defeated the Dark Lurker yet, Jordan.
Yeah, but I have to wait for the DLC, so then I'm ready to get on that.
The thing in the background is annoying, you know.
Okay, I'll turn it down.
No, it's like pure nostalgia for me.
No, fuck you.
Fuck your couch.
Fuck you.
Fuck your couch greatly.
Not my bed.
Before we do the segment, I forgot this really important, like, news. Sharknado 2 has a trailer.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
July 30th. Coming out.
I saw the picture for that. Ugh.
The subway guy.
Sharknado is like the shit. Like, come on, Soto.
I've actually never seen
Sharknado is life.
Sharknado is love. These bugs, please do not mess with me. You will die. But yeah, that's about it that I have. This awkward silence is lovely. I'm glad we're all interesting.
Indeed.
That's what happens, because we're no lifers.
Is this what the podcast has come to? Awkward silence?
Whatever, that's what it was always known to come to. We all knew this was going to happen.
We didn't have that last episode.
Yes, we did.
No, we didn't. I listened.
Yeah, it's just
was there.
Yes, we did. A lot of it was filled with sorrow.
Like on Twitter.
A lot of it. Goddamn. Yeah, and then a lot of it was filled with sorrow going. Like Sorrow's mic going. That was like that. I cut out like 5 minutes of just that noise.
Jordan.
Of just that noise.
Jordan.
Yeah.
Okay, hey. We're gonna...
River. What?
Jordan, do you get SoundCloud notifications?
No.
Okay.
Why?
Well, you're gonna wanna go there after the podcast. That's all I'm gonna say.
Why?
Why?
Can't go listen to it right now. Ben uploaded something zombie. Okay. Yeah, that's why I don't tell you. Can we get to the asking segment?
Okay.
The awesomely obvious questions?
I guess not.
What?
Sorrow, you were gonna say something?
Yep. Let's see. What is the most recent dream that you can remember?
Are you on ask? That's my job, you bitch. Hey, somebody's asking, echoing.
It might be me. Sorry. I don't know how to fix that.
Oh, well. It's not that loud.
You want to ask Sorrow's question? I think it's
no, because Sorrow's question is not legit. He didn't come from the source of me.
Well, I'm going to answer it.
Okay, well, I don't know what the question was. I wasn't listening.
What was the most recent dream you had? I kind of remember the one I had waking up today. It was weird. I was, like, back at my school, but my family was there, which was weird. And I was, like, lying on my bed, but not my school bed. And I'm going to kill whoever's breathing. And we were just watching
I just go look at Penn State. Sorry. Shut up.
Not yet. And
I don't remember much of what happened, but it was interesting. I remember waking up and being like, oh, it was interesting. Yeah, so basically, you learned nothing from that.
I can't remember. They're usually repeats of dreams, but then there's it adds an extension to it. Or something. So I can't remember.
What about you, Sarah?
Alright, let's see, so. Amanda was a girl.
No, that's a boring dream. That's dumb. That's a boring dream.
Let's see, so. The man wakes up to his little
girl. No, that one's stupid too. That one's stupid too.
He let us go to and we had nothing.
Whatever, I was supposed to ask the questions, so he stole my job. Why should I let him do anything?
Uh-huh. Right.
Okay, carry on.
As I was saying, so...
Hurry the fuck up.
They rush into the house, mm-hmm. and there's a strange person there, and they start waving him down to get in his car. He's a pretty
dude, is this a story about, I was going to say if this was The Purge, the second Purge movie. Okay, what?
So after they get in the car with him, they decide to just ditch the person. They leave, they get off the car, it's like the middle of a highway. And as they're walking around, they for some reason get in another abandoned car. And there's a beehive in there. And they're freaking out, they pull that out. And then all of a sudden there's, for some reason, giant bees everywhere, stinging people, and all of a sudden some of them start talking to the characters. They take them prisoner, and they have them in some, like, underground cell.
And they have sex with them?
The main character turns into Mario.
I don't know. Okay.
And so... He starts breaking through, like, the ceiling, you know, like, jumping and breaking through it, and he gets out in there, and he finds out that Luigi's working with the giant bees. And they start fighting, and that's
fuck Luigi.
Well, thank you, Sarah.
How's that?
Next fanfic idea. What? This is why you should have a. You can write down all these amazing dreams on your blog, and everyone would read it, and you blog it and love it.
Yeah, Sorrow, get your tumbling on.
And these bugs need to die.
Are we ready for the next question?
So do we have a name?
Shut up, Sorrow.
What?
Oh, I thought he wasn't going.
Am I going?
Yeah, go.
What's the question?
How many drugs have you taken?
What is it, Tom?
What's the most recent dream that you've had that you can remember?
What is the most recent dream I've had?
My question was a joke, but... Yeah, my question was a joke.
Most recent dream I had,
Renee was the bay.
Yeah, that's the only dream that's worth remembering. I don't know.
That's okay. None of us know either.
None of us did except for Sorrow. So, are we going to the
yes, we're going to the next question. Questions. Okay.
Do you have a name for this segment?
I'm not gonna fall for this, because I asked last week, and you, talked at me like I was an insane moron.
Yeah, but I changed my mind since then.
Well, what do you want to call it?
I guess Ripper we asks. Can decide that tomorrow. I don't know, you're good at making up words, but...
Go fuck yourself and ask me a question. That's what it's gonna be. So that's how you start it. Like, whenever, if you just randomly want a question, just be like, go fuck yourself and ask me a question. That's how you do it. Okay?
And then the segment starts up.
Yeah, and then it doesn't even have to be a segment. You could just, in the middle of, like, silence happening, you could just ask for a question. Okay. Mm-hmm. Somebody started up.
Go fuck yourself and ask me a question.
If you could hug anyone right now, who would it be?
Status. Status. Status or die. Stan the man. Stan the man. Or Cersei.
Stan the man.
That person doesn't sound like they're Arya or any other character I care about, so.
Yeah, Arya and Gendry. That's all that matters.
Gendry.
Whatever. I don't watch it that much.
Not whatever.
Next.
Sorrow, who would you hug?
I'd hug you, Ripper.
You'd hug me? If you hug me, I have to put my dick out and fuck you, so.
Nice.
And then, after that response, I'd hug my puppy, because he's still having a nightmare.
Aww. Sweet.
Now somebody say, go fuck yourself and ask me a question.
No,
I was joking. Okay, if the whole world were listening, what would you say? And remember, the whole world is listening right now. At any point, anybody in the world can hear this. What?
The book was
if
better.
The whole world is listening right now, I would just, I'd walk up, because I'd assume I'm on a stage, and I'd walk over to the mic, and I'd scream, Renee. Then I'd drop the mic and walk away. That's how that would work for me.
That's a good answer.
Yeah.
Well, now the whole world has heard you say Renee.
You're right, Renee.
You know, I don't think we mentioned that, because we mentioned it last week, that this is the Renegade rendition, but I think we just said this is Ocelus back up, so.
I see it.
Yeah, you ruined the intro. We got to do the whole thing again.
Sorry. Whoa, you can calm down there. I've already lost train of thought on what the first things we even talked about were. Yeah, I just remember it involving ideas, but I don't remember anything I said. Carry on. But what would you say if the whole... What would you say right now since the whole world is listening?
I don't give a fuck what the world wants to hear.
Wait, what? What did you say?
I would...
The night is dark and full of terror.
Bravo. Sorry?
The book was better?
No, can I change
no
it?
No one would
can
know what you're
one?
Talking about.
No, you're stuck. Deal with it.
I know what he's gonna say. Wait. So yeah, I wanna hear it. I know what you're gonna say.
Really?
Alright, nothing?
Yeah.
Go!
No one fucking understands.
No one understands! I read the fucking book.
No.
I thought you were gonna say I read the fucking book.
That falls under the same category.
Okay. Next question. These bugs are going to be the bane of my existence. It is definitely going to make me leave.
Okay, the next question is, have you ever fired a real gun?
No. Yep. I don't like guns.
Me and Sarah are from Texas, so the answer is, what gun haven't we fired?
I'm the only one who hasn't. I mean, I've played paintball. Does that count?
Did you get really close to anybody and shoot them in the eye?
No.
Then no.
Okay. So I guess then
how about
no.
You, Jordan?
He said he's fired a rifle. Okay, next question. Which celebrity would you like to meet?
Ooh, Lana Perla. Lana Perla,
Sophie Turner.
Julianne Moore, Kate Mulgrew, Ryan...
Hey, Romy, shut up. It was one. It was which celebrity? One celebrity, not like all of them.
I'm not naming all of them.
You're naming a lot of them.
I named like five.
That's a lot. Especially since some of us haven't named any yet.
Well, I already named ones better than whatever you guys are going to name, so...
Dude, I found a cat in a tree. So, anyways, who do y'all want to meet?
Sophie Turner. Sophie Turner or die.
Oh, I was expecting you to give like 15 names because Romy did. No, I wouldn't want to meet my celebrities. In fact, if anything, it would have been the Rooster Teeth people. I've already met them. It wasn't all that exciting because I'm not a very excited person about things. It was cool. Nah, because meeting people, like, it's not what it's cracked up to be, at least not for me, anyway. So it's
not
like,
me.
Eh? No, I haven't.
Hi.
You're on Xbox. Hi, you're Romy. But, it's, like, I don't want to meet the people because then it's just going to be me awkwardly standing and saying, like, hi. You know, I wouldn't be awkward when I said hi. I'd be pretty confident. I'd be like, you know, hello. I've actually did that. I did that multiple times throughout RTX and whatever. But it's just, I'm not going to have a conversation, probably, because what are we going to talk about? Hello, I have nothing to say because I'm an awkward person, don't have a life of any kind or any interest.
I would stand in front of Lana Perla
Sorrow,
and not talk.
Sorrow never answered. Sorrow never answered.
Let's see.
Oh, wait, before you answer, it's also, like, a lot of the people that, like, even if you meet them, they're like, oh, they're really happy that you're a fan or whatever, but it's like, they don't actually care. It's likely that they're not going to remember your existence. They're just going to forget that, you know, they're like, oh, yeah, okay, bye, and then, you know, never notice you ever again, so, it's like, whatever.
Remember,
yeah, they'd remember Romy. Romy would make sure of it. Well, yeah. if you had me with you and you were meeting a celebrity, you'd get remembered. I can guarantee it. I've already made it happen. Multiple times.
Okay.
Yeah, because I am a badass. But you wouldn't remember me specifically. No, he didn't. I'm giving him time to think of an answer.
Yeah, thank you.
While I find rupees in the grass.
I was actually going to say John Titor.
Who's that?
You should look him up, it's interesting.
Okay, no.
You should look him up.
I did.
Next question.
Well, you should explain it to us.
Or Kiefer Sutherland?
I couldn't do it enough justice.
Doing your mom. Okay,
doing your mom.
Okay. If there is one thing that you could change about the past, what would that be?
There is a lot I'd do.
I'd go back and make sure I kept all my remembered where all my Game Boy Color games were, because this is fun. Actually, no joke, I would actually go back and make sure I didn't fucking lose them. All of them, at one time. All of them. All gone. Because fucking who knows. I lost Crystal. It's gone. They didn't remake it. I lost the Pokemon game Crystal.
Oh.
Anyone else want to answer?
Yeah, I got one.
What would you do?
You didn't like my answer, Jordan?
If I could go back.
Who powers. What?
If I could go back, I would probably not change anything because I would have wanted to make it so I wouldn't meet you all.
Yeah, Sorrow, because if you never met me, you wouldn't get to live in San Antonio. He would know. He would make sure that he didn't do anything so he could meet us.
Oh, we just do everything the same.
Yeah, that's boring.
Yeah, that's what I would do.
You'd go back. You'd have at least said you'd go back and then meet me again, because, like, I'm me. Like, we could have played on Halo 3 again, on Sephiroth, going in an elephant, doing roleplay of different people trying to get on the elephant. Yeah, I remember the first lady match. That's right. Dedication.
That's why, see? I'd go back and get to do
the
all that again.
The barbershop, Romie. The barbershop. Barbershop.
That was me and you on Call of Duty, That was... I'd go back and I'd stop Drunk Romie from saying things. Yeah.
Ryan 2.0.
A lot of things. No, what? That doesn't exist.
In my mind, it does.
Let's not bring up that name on this podcast. It's foul.
You guys want to have Rylan as a special guest?
How about never? Sure.
Oh, that reminds me, Jordan showed me his whoopee cushion video. The horror.
Okay. Jordan, you didn't answer.
It was terrifying.
Answer what?
You didn't answer the question.
What was the question?
What would you go back and change in the past, right? How would it?
Yeah, if you could go back, if there's one thing that you could change.
That was terrible. Romie, we all know that. That was unavoidable.
Watching The Walking Dead.
You can say nothing. It's okay.
Yeah, but I want to say something.
What was your favorite toy as a child? Game Boy Color, Pokemon Crystal.
I used to have, from the movie Small Soldiers. I love that movie. I used to have...
I have that movie.
I think it was Arthur. Archer. Indian kind of looking person. Like,
yeah.
The weird alien Indian thing. I used to have a toy of him. And that was my favorite. And he would have a bow. And that was awesome.
Huh. That's cool.
Yeah. Small Soldiers. I love that movie. It's also a very inappropriate movie.
That's a good game.
I look back at it.
That's a good game.
Anyone else?
No, that game's called Toy Soldiers.
I thought Tara would actually get on this question faster than me.
Yeah, I thought he was going to have an orgasm. Like Olaf?
Disappointed me, Sorrow. Dead to me.
You're still not answering, Sorrow.
Well, I'm waiting for Jordan to answer.
He's answered!
Oh, did he?
What
was Jordan's answer?
Yes!
Yeah.
Legos!
What? Oh, Legos?
Mm-hmm.
Dumbass.
I can't say, honestly.
I'm sorry, my favorite toy was my penis.
Wow.
Okay, then you're over here.
I think I captured your story. What did you say, though?
I had several. I can't say there's just one that I really enjoyed.
So name them all.
Alright, let's see. I really enjoyed Shenmue from Dreamcast.
Okay, there you go. There's the answer. All right, the next question is, post a selfie.
Really?
It really is. That's the next one. See, we should have made one. We should have made an Instagram account just so we could do it every time post a selfie came up. So am I. Okay, Sorrow, continue. I thought Sorrow was going to continue. I thought you were going to continue.
It's okay. Question's over.
With the toys. Alright.
My favorite toy was when Daddy put it in Mommy for 9 months.
I love putting it in Mommy for 9 months.
Interesting. We're going to go on to the next question now.
I didn't. I got it after I said it. The next question is
into the podcast to cover incest yet, so yeah.
The next question is, hold on, wait, I have a story about that. Incest.
Oh god.
Okay. So
when your sentence starts off, but I have a story about incest.
At RTX, I actually met a couple of people who were into incest. They expressed that they were going to try it out that day.
Wow.
Well, you know what they say, incest is wincest.
It sure is.
Hells yeah.
I heard that been said, so.
It has been said quite a bit. And, I mean, you know, it's whatever. There's nothing wrong with incest. It's just, you know, it's the same as other sex, just don't have it on top of me. I have no clue what happened to them afterwards. They left. They probably went and had sex with each other. And the next question is actually, do you need any help? The answer is yes, all of us.
Yes. Yeah.
Sorrow has it memorized. Okay, I'll go to the beach. What's at the beach? Sorrow's gonna walk me through the game. There. Find what?
Yeah, I played loads of it. You can find some of your gear there.
Like what? I can't find anything. I can't go anywhere. I have the wooden sword already. Yeah.
Talk to some of the people around the village.
I did talk to some of the people around the village. I talked to all the people around the village.
Let's see.
Okay, anyways, so the next question is, do you need any help? Yes, we all need help in this party. Okay, when you go to a movie, do you like to sit in the back, middle, or front? Or make out with your family? Sorrow has an answer after I say, or make out with your family.
Go on, Sorrow. Sorry, you answer first. This is new. Sorrow's answering first. Whoa. Okay.
I like to sit farthest away from the loud people.
So your family.
Are they black?
Wait a second. Shut up, Rippy. It depends on the movie for me. The comedy. Like in the middle with my friends so we can laugh and annoy the people behind and in front of us. If it's something that I want to pay attention to, I'll sit up front. And if it's a superhero movie, I'll sit in the back. Because I want to pay attention with the least amount of noise.
I want to sit around away from my family.
The people you went to the movies with.
Yes, actually. Very much so. Yep. High five. Uh-oh. What did I just start in here?
What?
Where do you like to sit when you go to the movies?
I like to sit on the aisle, movies, so I'm the first one out.
I actually had to do that when I went to go see the
I actually do that in case there's like a terrorist attack or there's like...
Wow. So just in case somebody decides they're gonna shoot up the theater, you're gonna sit right next to the door, you know, where they don't plan on like locking it or putting anything in the way.
See, what's gonna happen is they're going to walk in, Jordan's gonna see that they're gonna do that, and before yelling or trying to warn anyone or try to stop the guy, he's just gonna walk out. Probably like tell someone at the concession stand, hey, something might be happening over at Theater 6, but I wouldn't know.
So,
I left.
Jordan, just out of curiosity, do you not have, like, police officers in your theater?
No.
Sorrow.
Do they even have police? They have mooses.
Oh, man. I ran into some people from Canada at RTX. They kept making jokes about each other's relationship statuses. There was a lot of sexual tension between them. It was kind of weird.
This is getting annoying with these bugs. Really annoying.
Alright, we'll go to the next question. What's the most interesting object in your room? I think we did that last time.
Sorrow can say what his is, but next question.
No, we did, okay. Well, what's your opinion about the death penalty?
Ah, so we hit one. The last time we started off with, like, one of the big questions. Now, okay, who's gonna go first?
If you hate the Game of Thrones book, then yeah, go fuck yourself.
I don't think that was the question, but okay.
Nope.
That's nope. I improvised.
Fuck, shit.
Well, no. Me and Starro are from Texas, where they actually implement the death penalty at least once a year.
Annually.
We all get to go out and watch. We throw stones at them. Just, okay.
Wow. You don't go to that public event over?
No, I'm usually I just stay inside. Oh, man, so there are way too many strays in San Antonio, and so there are, like, all the shelters are filled all the time. And so a lot of the shelters actually have, like, a 1 to 3 day, or actually most of them are, they just have a 1 day, like, they can stay for 1 day, then they have to euthanize them. Which means kill, if you don't. Yeah. Which, that's a lot of, there was, like, a huge issue with it because, I mean, there still is, but they've changed it now where if they find the dog with a collar or, like, a chip or something, then they have up to a week to come in and get the dog. But, like, if they were, they would find a dog, they would, like, get a dog off the street. And the next day, if nobody came to claim it, even if it had a chip or something. I'm sorry, nice. Even if it had a chip, if nobody came to claim it, they would just kill it the next, like, the day after. So people who would lose their dog for, like, 2 days, they didn't know where it was, couldn't find it, find out, oh, your dog, we found it, we picked it up, we killed it.
Lovely.
It's a bunch of nonsense.
I like how we strayed away from the original question, but we can just go to the next one, I guess.
That is the death penalty. It's the doggy death penalty.
Jordan gave the Game of Thrones one, give the dog.
At least the dog one was relative.
Jordan just started screaming Game of Thrones stuff again.
Yeah.
What was the best advice you've ever received?
Oh, received. Oh.
Don't go to King's Landing.
I was about to go ham.
Sorrow, go to the received. Hospital.
Yes, Sorrow, go to the hospital.
The best advice I've ever received. Well, I've never really listened to
Wait,
any of the
stop.
Advice I've ever received. So. They're all normally very good.
I'll just give some advice for the people.
Wait, what?
Give some advice to the people listening.
Oh, you want... I'm majoring in psychology, so I can so do this. I'm, like, qualified, right? No. let's see. Let's go Disney on this. Always follow your heart. Yeah.
Really? Hey, Romie, go kill yourself.
Isn't that what you said? That's not what my heart wants me to follow.
Lol.
I don't really know what to say. Don't doubt yourself. I do that a lot.
Sorrow, so you know, I found the way.
Oh, nice.
He found this delay.
It's Link's Awakening that you're playing, right? Not the Oracle ones?
I don't know. I would check, but I feel like the game hasn't saved. I don't want to just turn it off.
Here's an issue. When you turned it on, was there a giant egg on the screen?
I don't know. I wasn't looking at it. We were doing a podcast.
Hey, when you started it off, were you sinking in a bed?
What?
When the game started, did like a girl wake you up while you're sleeping in some random bed?
No.
I just
started off in the middle of a cave.
Oh. Okay.
This is Game Boy Color.
Yeah, there's three for
that. I don't know if it's saved. I don't know if it's saved. Anyway, so advice, guys. Sorrow, do you have any advice? What's the best advice you've ever received? And then if you don't have any advice you've ever received, give some advice to the audience.
I already told you what the best advice I received was.
When? Say it again.
Sorrow, go to the hospital.
Oh, yeah, never mind. Yeah, give some advice to the audience.
Let's see. Jordan, give me some time to answer this.
Jordan, he wants you to answer the question.
Answer questions. So you can have time to think. I think that's how this works.
Is it Jordan? I'm thinking too.
Oh,
yeah.
That's how it's worked so far.
Best device I've seen.
Join the Flaming Ninja.
No, that was the best advice I ever received.
Weird game at the
I have a legitimate answer, I guess.
I have one too.
No matter what you do, just do it confidently and nobody's gonna ask you a question. You wanna break into some kind of facility? Act like you work in that facility.
That's right. You gotta stay true to your lies. You gotta make them real.
For real though. Like if you're doing anything, if you just do it with confidence, it's easier to do and also less people bother you.
Nassara, you said you had something?
Yeah, think for yourselves.
That sounded weird how he said that, right?
Yeah.
Think for yourselves.
He's like, think for yourselves.
And fade off into the distance, think for yourselves. And then he just disappears, like, oh, okay. He's like, kids are sitting on a bench, and he'll walk up to them, think for yourselves. They get the system, and then just walk off, and like...
Okay then.
But really, you
should. Cause I like to wear like trench coats, so it's like imagine him wearing a black trench coat, walking up to you, and just being like, "Think for yourselves," and then just walks away.
All right, I'm gonna assume this game saved itself. I'm just gonna turn it off.
So I think like maybe two more questions, and then you can close it off.
Okay. After that, we have to think for ourselves. Think for yourself. Alright, next. Alrighty, now let me hashtag that real quick.
Think for yourself. So that could be like your catchphrase for your action movie. Think for yourself.
That's your like iconic line.
You've
like flooded a room full of people for like the sake of like saving someone or something action movie, and there was explosions. Obviously, you go up to like the main bad guy, and as you're about to shoot him, you're like, think for yourselves, and then you kill him.
Well, I don't know why I don't have this plugged in.
Think for yourself.
And then you grab, like, whatever babe you just saved, and you walk off into the distance.
The
sorrow.
Okay. Hashtag the sorrow.
Hashtag the... We already did that one.
I know, I just wanted to bring it back up.
Hashtag Ricky the Avenger. There we go.
Okay.
Most of our podcast is usually us just talking about how amazing sorrow is.
I actually,
lots of hashtags.
Yeah, we... Whatever, that's 5 total. Actually, I think that's only 4 total.
Think for yourself.
Okay, so, do we have another question?
What was Jordan's answer?
Oh, yeah.
Still thinking.
Oh, my God.
God.
Jordan, you were thinking this entire time, were you?
No, he wasn't.
I am.
He was thinking about thinking for himself. Actually, you know what? Is that your best piece of advice, Jordan? That's your best piece of advice. Think for yourself. Sorrow just advised you to think for yourself, and now you will.
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
Alright.
Alrighty then.
What is something?
Make it a good one.
What is something you find hard to stop once you have started?
Okay then.
I know something that I find hard to stop.
No one's mind went incredibly great in that question. No, was I the only one?
No, you weren't.
Does anyone want to say? Oh, okay, good. I can't be the only one with a dirty mind in here. Like, come on.
I mean, obviously those of filthy, filthy minds like Romy's would obviously start thinking about rolling around in the dirt.
Once I start rolling around in that dirt, there's no stopping me. I'm gonna just keep going. No, nothing gonna stop me until I'm done.
That's what I'm gonna name the episode. Romy Rolls in Dirt.
What? Romy Rolls in Dirt.
This episode, Romy Rolls in the Dirt.
Wow.
That's the name. Okay.
And then he never takes a shower. That's why he looks the way he does.
I thought that was a racist comment, so I'm going to kill you. mean, because I'm beautiful, no matter
it's
what
It's a racial
say.
Comment, not racist.
Your words can't,
everybody
your
misuses
words can't
the word racist.
Down. Anyway, anyone else going to actually answer?
Masturbating.
Yeah, there you go. Someone said it. Someone said the obvious. Thank you.
Is it really hard for you to stop that? I don't have a problem with that.
I wasn't saying me. It was just the joke. It was there. And I was like...
Mm-hmm. Sure. Sure. Okay.
It's okay, Romy.
Whatever. We believe it.
Oh, my God. Anyone else going to answer?
It's kind of hard to stop a train once you get it going.
Okay, then.
Okay.
In fact, the train never stops. And if you guys were up to date on, your Ray memes, you would, understand that reference.
Ray William Johnson?
No, Ray Narvaez Jr.
Not really.
Okay,
go away.
William Johnson can go fuck himself and give me a question.
Okay,
then. And think for yourself. And he can go think for himself as well.
Sorry, you can go think for yourself.
Okay.
Ricky the Avenger.
So you can go away with that.
Like, talking about a show or movie that I like. It's hard to get me to shut up. Once I start talking about it, I will prove all audiences wrong if they are against whatever it is.
Is that why we have a podcast where when you mention movies, it's for like 5 minutes and then nothing else?
Yeah. Well, if you guys ever caught up on up-to-date shows, I wouldn't mind doing like
hey, a Romie.
Segment with whoever's caught up. And
why don't you go watch some 2.5 minute to 5 minute videos that come out once a week, and you know maybe we might have something to talk about. It might have something to do with the colors red and blue. They might even have a whole convention that's related to it. You know, then maybe we might have something to talk about.
Anyone else need to answer?
I'm just gonna,
I'm in actual show. Once that's on my TV, then we can talk.
actually, it's on Netflix, Romy, so,
yeah,
go fuck yourself. Guess what? They're also making a movie. You gonna see that movie?
Yeah, I am.
Lies.
Okay.
Lies and slander.
Uh-oh, lies.
Lies and slander. Gotta get the slander part.
Are the other
is anybody gonna answer this question? Fucking question?
Yeah. Alright.
Thank you.
Let's see. Dark Souls.
You do have an addiction to that,
yeah.
Don't you?
Yeah, once I start playing, I usually have to play the whole game again.
I have a legitimate answer. Heroin is kind of hard to stop once you've started.
Oh my god. First you say a train, now this. Go away.
The train's a reference. This is just a joke.
I bet it's pretty hard to stop a train when you're doing heroin as well.
I bet it's easier to stop a train when you're doing heroin. Because you'll just derail that.
Yeah,
it
makes you feel more pervert.
What if you were rolling in the dirt while you were doing the heroin? Then you're already preoccupied, and you won't be able
to stop
the train.
Where's the dirt on the train?
Dude, it's taking a 36-hour nap's kind of hard to stop.
Going into a coma can be hard to stop as well, so...
That's why it's a 36-hour nap.
Wow.
Has anybody else technically been in a coma? No? Just me?
I don't think I've technically been in one. Jordan, are you
gonna
answer?
Unless I'm in one right now.
Yeah, you probably are, Sorrow. I don't know who would imagine any of this but you.
If you are, then you have a really shitty coma, because we're part of it, so...
That's actually probably the best coma of his life. He's just been... He's probably some, like, super pop star, and he's just been wanting to be alone forever. And now he gets to live the life of having only internet friends and never talking to people in person. This is his lonely life, hanging out with his internet friends.
We gave you enough time to...
What was the question?
Living the dream, Ripper.
Wow. What was the question?
That you start... What was the question? It's like,
what's something that's hard to stop? What's something that's hard to stop once you've started?
Reading the books.
Reading Game of Thrones for Jordan.
Quite parallel to my answer.
Right. All right, so is this going to be the last one?
So you want to answer one more? Are we down for one more before we start plugs?
Yeah, let's do one more.
What would someone have to do to make you dislike them immediately?
Ooh. Be Ripper.
No, my answer.
I was going to say be Renee. And actually, you did just steal Jordan's answer.
Wait, what?
Romy, you did actually steal Jordan's answer.
How did I steal Jordan's?
Be Ripper.
That is
legitimately Jordan's answer. He's given that answer on ask.
How am I gonna know that? I'm not a fan of, rude people. Like, when someone's rude when you just meet them, that kind of...
Hey, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Alright, Sorrow, what would somebody have to do? It's not hard. I could answer it for you right now.
Okay, let's hear.
Try to have a conversation with you while you're on the toilet.
So I've done that.
No, but that would definitely make him dislike them immediately. Sorry, you don't like people having conversations. You don't like having conversations with people as it is now. If you were taking a massive shit, diarrhea spewing out of your asshole, and somebody's in the stall next to you like, how's it going over there, buddy? You would hate that person.
I wouldn't. I'd be like, yeah, that's pretty good. A really rough one.
I'd be like, I would be like, dude, you can't smell it? Hold on.
You want me to pass you some?
Pass some what?
That's some shit.
Toilet paper.
No, sorrow, because I think for myself.
Think for yourself.
Fucking high, sorrow.
Are you fucking high? Sensory organs, are you fucking high?
Sensory organs.
Fucking, when I, like, I probably told you guys, I know Jordan knows he was fucking there. Fucking mentioned sensory, sorrow, like, they were wondering what organs are, like, the organs that sense things. But, like what organ is your eye? Because, you know, you have, fucking respiratory organs, you have circulatory organs and stuff. Whatever, like, what are the organs that sense things, like your tongue and your eye and stuff? I was like, well, those are sensory organs. And they were both, like, silent. They're like, are you fucking high? Ripper, are you high? You fucking sensory organs? And then they fucking Googled it, and they're like, holy shit, that's a real thing?
I didn't Google it.
Sensory organ. Yeah, Rylan did, and you just agreed with him.
Like I said, Rylan and his lap dog.
And so it was like, were you Arya and Rylan was the hound? Or like the other way around?
Hey, yeah.
Anyway, Jordan didn't answer whatever the question was.
Jordan hasn't been answering any of these.
Did I have?
You take 9 years.
Okay.
And you give something unrelated this whole time.
Game of Thrones, YOLO, flag.
Actually, you know, for Jordan, that could be a legitimate answer. Starting to watch Game of Thrones.
Oh, what about the people who, like, spoil it on YouTube? Don't you automatically hate those people?
Most of those people just read the wiki, so those people don't count for anything.
What about somebody who's read the books? Wait, what if somebody was, like, super good friends with J.J.R. Martin? and next book. Oh, he kicked me from the party. He kicked me from the
party. So are we done here now? Because we talked in about 2 hours now.
I have to hashtag J.J.R. Martin.
Because
one of you said it.
I did.
Clothing? Well, I can put on clothes. Yeah? I can put on clothes if you want.
Well, I said,
you said clothing. Are we going to start clothing?
I am
sitting naked.
Are we going to start closing down now? I think
like what, our business? We just started selling t-shirts. Why would we close down the store?
What?
That throw you guys off?
I'm so confused right now.
Do we have t-shirts?
What the fuck are you guys confused about? Why would we ever make a t-shirt? I'm the only person who would have to deal with that, and I would not do it.
Why not?
You guys want to give me some money? You want to guarantee me some sales of shirts? I can get them made per order.
Yeah, we can make all the Ricky the Avenger shirts. Or the
I'd be fine with that.
I live in mommy for 9 months shirts.
We should definitely make that a bracelet.
Or the thing for yourself headband. See, look, we had such a marketing strategy. Yeah, fuck yeah.
Oh my god, all of our hashtags are gonna be things. Hashtag the sorrow.
Hashtag the sorrow sneakers. You know, gotta have those. And it's like, it's like the engineer from Prometheus on both sides of the sneakers giving me a thumbs up.
Oh my god. So when we actually ever do get big, these are definitely gonna be things that are gonna get made.
Yeah.
You know I started with if, right, and changed it?
Yeah, I heard. I did enjoy it, though. I would wear a,
I would.
A, what was it?
Alright, so wait here. This is the list of the merchandise we would have, like, up to the point, right? Let me pull them up. So we would have a
t-shirt.
Yeah, we would. We'd have the standard Ocelus t-shirt, and we would have both. We'd have just the Ocelus Renegade rendition and the Ocelus t-shirt. And because, you know, I'm such a fabulous logo designer, it would look amazing, and everybody would adore you for it.
Hello.
But, so we would have the hashtag Ricky the Avenger, headband?
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And then, hashtag the sorrow sneakers. Wait, is think for yourself the headband? Yeah. Think for yourself is the headband. Hashtag Ricky the Avenger is another shirt? No, it should be a jacket. It's a jacket. Hashtag Ricky the Avenger is a jacket. So the quote part of Daddy stays in mommy for about 9 months. Is that could be combined with a hashtag sex ed by Ocelus.
Yeah, that could be. The 9 month part on like the front, and then sex ed by Ocelus on like the back.
Yeah, that'd be another shirt. And if we wanted a wristband or something, we could do the same. We could just do a. Part of Daddy stays in Mommy.
Wow.
For the wristband.
Oh, yeah. The Ocelus merchandise line.
What? How do
the
I have...
Ocelus swag.
33 photos and videos? Why? What is this? Is this me adding all the things? Oh, yeah, it is.
Okay, are we done?
Alright, Romie. Go ahead and start closing.
So, thank you if you stayed this long, which is like 2 hours, and I don't know who the hell would listen to us for 2 hours.
No one's gonna stay for this long.
Hey, this is definitely recording, right? Jesus Christ, we have been on here for 2 hours? Dude,
yeah.
I can't even upload this to SoundCloud. Hurry, go. I'll have to cut apart.
Thank you for joining us for Ocelus Renegade Rendition. Follow us.
Goodbye. Read the books.
On Twitter, at Ocelus, what else do we
have?
Twitter, Tumblr.
Jordan.
We each have different, handles to follow.
Okay,
YouTube,
Romy's Twitter is at RomyDogs. My Twitter is at TheRipper1928. Sorrow is something difficult. He can spell it out, or you can go listen to the last one. Jordan is at IMV2, or IMDraggerDetV2. Good luck with that. We gotta end this, otherwise it will be too long for SoundCloud.
Okay, thank you for joining us.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Play Dark Souls.
Read the book.
Yeah, don't listen to him, because think for yourselves.
Yeah, think for yourself.
You realize we are over 2 hours, so I'm gonna have to cut all of this extra stuff. So you all are trying to get the end line, and it's all gonna be cut out, and I have to edit it anyways.
I will be the last thing everybody hears. So fuck yourselves.